Okay, this is going to be another video about solving quadratic equation by factoring. And I just want to do a couple more examples where you might run into some things that weren't covered in the first few videos. Okay, so here we go. What I've got here is 3x squared minus 3x equals x squared plus 2. And it doesn't look like a quadratic equation at first, but if you think about it, I've got an x squared and an x squared. I can combine these terms. And my highest exponent, my largest exponent is going to be a 2. So I can put this into standard form, make it into a nice quadratic equation. What I want to do is get everything on one side, all the terms on one side. So I'll subtract x squared from both sides. And you know, you can subtract more than one thing at a time. So let's also subtract the 2 from both sides. Okay, let's see what I get. 3x squared minus x squared would just be an x squared. I'm sorry, it's 2x squared. 3x, I'm not subtracting anything from it, so I've still got that negative 3x, and I'm subtracting negative 2 from this side, so I get a negative 2. On the right side, I've subtracted x squared minus x squared, so they cancel, and 2 minus 2 cancels, so I've got my 0 over on the right. And now I've got a quadratic equation in standard form. Now I want to factor this left side. Looking at it, I realize that what I've got is a first coefficient, which is greater than 1. So I probably want to use the AC method. So I'm going to think of the number of the 2, the coefficient 2, as an A. The negative 3 is going to be the B. Negative 2 will be the C. And I want to multiply A times C. So 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. And for the B, I've got a negative 3. So I'm looking for two factors of 4 that I can multiply, of negative 4, that I can multiply together and get a negative 4, and add together and get a negative 3. So I know that one is positive and one is negative. So let's see what kind of factors I have for 4. But let's start with 1 and 4. And this is nice because 1 from 4 is 3, so I know their difference is 3. I've just got to figure out which one should be positive and which one should be negative. Since I want them to add up to negative 3, the 4 should be the negative number. So I'm going to have a 1 and a negative 4. And now I'll replace this negative 3 with a 1 and negative 4. So I'm going to get 2x squared. I'm going to start with my negative number, minus 4x plus 1x, okay, because this negative 4 and x add up to negative 3x, minus 2, that equals 0. And now I want to factor this by grouping, so I'm going to group the first two terms and the second two terms. I can factor 2x out of the first binomial, so I'm going to get 2x times x minus 2. And the second one, really the only thing I could factor out is a 1. So let's put a 1 there. Okay, I've got 2x times x minus 2 plus 1 times x minus 2. So since I've got an x minus 2 and an x minus 2, I'm going to make x minus 2 one of my factors. And my other factor will be 2x plus 1. And that equals 0. Now I'm going to take each of the factors and set it equal to 0. So I get x minus 2 equals 0. And 2x plus 1 equals 0. And solving the first one for x, I just add 2 to both sides. And I get x equals 2. Solving the second one, I get a negative, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. I'll get 2x equals negative 1. Then I divide both sides by 2. And I'm going to get x equals negative 1 half. So my answers should be x equals 2 and negative 1 half. Now we've got a fraction here. That shouldn't stop you from checking your answer. So Let's get something else to write on, and we'll check the answer. Okay, let's see. The original problem was 3x squared minus 3x equals x squared plus 2. And I want to see if the answers are x equals 2 and negative 1 half. Okay, so I'm going to plug the 2 in first. And I have 3 times 2 squared minus 3 times 2. The question is, does that equal 2 squared plus 2? So let's see what happens. 2 squared is 4. 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times 2 is 6, so I've got 12 minus 6. 2 squared is 4 plus 2. 12 minus 6, put my question mark there. 12 minus 6 is 6. 4 plus 2 is 6. So this answer checks. The x equals 2. Now we'll do the fraction part. A lot of students don't like fractions, and because they don't like them, they ignore them, and they avoid them, and then when you avoid them, they become harder. So let's just do it. Okay, 3 times negative 1 half squared minus 3 times negative 1 half. We want to see, does that equal negative 1 half squared plus 2? Okay, so I'm squaring negative 1 half. When I square a negative number, it's positive, so I don't have to worry about this negative sign here. I'm squaring a fraction, which means I'm distributing this 2 to the numerator and the denominator. So I'm going to get 3 times 1 squared is 1, and 2 squared is 4, minus, oh, I've got a minus 3 times minus 1 half, so that's plus. Plus 3 times 1 half, I just multiply the numerators, 3 times 1 is 3, over 2. Negative 1 half squared, well, we did that before, that's 1 quarter, plus 2. Okay, let's see what we can do. It looks like I'd like my common denominator. Actually, let's just multiply this 3 times 1 quarter. That's going to give me 3 fourths plus 3 halves equals 1 quarter plus 2. I'm going to write that as 2 over 1 so I can think of everything as a fraction. My common denominator is 4, so I'm going to multiply everything by 4. These two 4s will cancel. I'll get a 3. I can factor out a 2 here, and I'll get 2 times 3 is 6. These 4s will cancel, and I'll get a 1. 4 times 2 is 8. I have to keep writing my question mark. 3 plus 6 is 9. 1 plus 8 is 9. So both of my answers check. Okay, I think that's about all I have time for. So good luck with all of this. Do plenty of practice. I'll see you next time.